Hey everyone, welcome to your first set of video notes for AP Psych 2017-2018. Me and these two little people on the screen here are super excited that you are taking this class and that we get to talk psych all year. So go ahead and get out your objective sheet that I gave you in class today and let's get started. The first thing that we're going to learn about this year is the basic history of psychology. Where did it come from and how did it develop as a science? And I think this quote by cognitive psychologist Hermann Ebbinghaus is really fitting. He says that psychology has a long past but a short history. And it seems kind of contradictory at first when you read it, but it fits in really well. When we talk about the history of psychology, we divide it up into three eras. We have the pre-scientific psychology, we've got psychology when it finally develops as a science, and then we have contemporary psychology. And when we say contemporary, we mean like modern day psychology. So when Hermann says that psychology has a long past, what he means is that for thousands of years, people have been asking questions about the mind. They've been trying to study the mind. But when it comes to actually taking those questions about human behavior and human mind and putting them with the scientific method to scientifically measure them out, gather data on those things, that has been relatively short, only since around the late 1800s. And then the contemporary side, that we're going to kind of look at how do psychologists today in 2017 apply all the stuff that they know about psychology to current events and current things that people are going through. So in today's video, though, we're only going to be looking at the pre-scientific era of psychology. One of the biggest influencers on psychology today was the study of philosophy. So let's break down the etymology of the word philosophy. It breaks down into two words, philos and sophia. Philos means lover and sophia means wisdom. So a philosopher is a lover of wisdom. And it's really easy to see how this field influenced psychology because philosophy asks big questions about life, about human behavior, about the human mind. For example, the philosophers ask, who am I? Why do I do the things that I do? Why am I here? A psychologist asks, why do I dream? Why do I remember things? Why does my body respond when XYZ happens? So it's they're really similar in asking those big questions about life and wanting to know answers to meaningful questions. So who are some of the philosophers that influence psychology? There are two big ones that you're going to want to know, Socrates and Aristotle. So Socrates was famous for challenging the establishment in ancient Athens. And a famous quote that he has was, "Know thyself." Socrates wanted to know himself and know a lot about life. And how did he do that? He did that by asking questions. He'd ask a lot of deep questions to the established leaders that they didn't really like. And so ultimately, what we got from his method of asking questions was this thing called the Socratic method, which is actually like a way of having a discussion based on Socrates' method of asking questions. And ultimately, he was sentenced to death because he refused to stop asking questions. His questions began to annoy the establishment. He challenged their authority based on his questions. And so they gave him a choice. They said, you can either stop asking questions or you can drink this hemlock and essentially commit suicide. And Socrates ultimately chose death. And his last words, which I think are very fitting for psychology, were, the unexamined life is not worth living. And I love that because how many people today go through the motions and never really examine their life? Psychology is all about examining your life, taking, intentional time outside of your crazy busy schedule and working through the why behind why we as people do the things that we do. He also heavily influenced psychotherapy. So if you've ever been to a psychologist before, they ask some tough questions, but they ask questions that really are trying to get to the soul, your soul, trying to get to the heart of the problem, so that they can help you and that they can let you live a more full life. And so, lots and lots of influence from Socrates, for psychology. The second philosopher is Aristotle, who was actually a student of Plato, who was a student of Socrates, so they kind of were all related. But Aristotle disagreed with Socrates. So Socrates asked questions and thought that knowledge came from within, that you were born with knowledge and how you got it out was by asking questions. Aristotle, on the other hand, came up with this thing called empiricism. And so he thought, rather than knowledge coming from within, knowledge comes through your experiences, through your senses. So if you've ever heard of John Locke and his tabula rasa idea that we're all born with as like a blank slate, that's what tabula rasa means, blank slate, and that the only thing that drives our development as human beings is our experiences, is our environment, nothing that we're in born with ourselves. That was an idea piggybacked off of Aristotle's idea of empiricism, that knowledge only comes through experience, and so therefore, when you're going to do something scientific, it should only come through observation, not through studying of the mental processes. So Socrates, would say, let's study the mind, it's important. Aristotle would say, no, we can't observe the mind, we can't ex I can't experience your mind, it's super subjective. So he was more along the lines of the behavior part of the definition of psychology, because it's so difficult to observe the mind. So with these two philosophers, Socrates and Aristotle, it's important to know that they differ in terms of how they explain why people are the way they are. Socrates has more of a nature perspective that we're inborn with things that make us who we are, while Aristotle has more of a nurture perspective that it's our environmental experiences and life experiences that shape who we are. And this is such a huge question of psychology today. Are we who we are more because of nature or nurture? Because we're born that way or because of our environmental experiences that we have during our lives? So think back to these two when we come to this nature nurture question. And so that's pretty much it, guys, for this video. I just wanted to touch on the pre-scientific psychology history, in that basically all you need to remember is that for thousands of years before 1879, a bunch of old people have been asking questions about the human mind, the human behavior, why we do what we do, and all those questions ultimately led to an actual science being formed out of it. And that's what we will discuss next time. See you guys in class.